Mr. Hota, morning, and thanks so much for joining in. One of the key positives my colleague Anisha pointed out was the sizable improvement in order inflows. And BEML, if you can highlight the trends and how you see 2019 shaping out.
Well, I'm happy to say that we have just been awarded the order for Mumbai Line 2 and Line 7. That's a 3,000 crore order. It takes my order book to almost 10,000. This is the biggest order ever that we have received in BEML. It also has an optional 126 cars. That's another 1,000 crores. And the entire rail and metro is looking very good to us. Besides the metro in Mumbai, we are looking at certain orders in Bangalore. We are undergoing the execution of order at Calcutta. We are also expecting some orders from Delhi. Plus, there are other places like Pune and Vizag. There are other opportunities as well in the rail and metro. For example, the freight is expected to almost triple by the year 2030 from today. There's a new rail policy which talks of strengthening the existing corridors and looking at new corridors. There's also a market for suburban trains to move it to IGBT three-phase. It'll run like a metro instead of being pulled by a locomotive. So that's another option for us. We are also looking at rail grinding machines, track laying machines. We are also looking at the high speed between Mumbai and Ahmedabad, for which we have a tie-up with Hitachi. So net-net, the entire rail and metro is looking very good for us. This is aided and buoyed by the fact that the Make in India policy of the Honorable Prime Minister, that has also helped us in a very big way. Not to speak of the other two verticals that we have, which is mining and construction and defense, both of which are looking good. Defense, of course, there are some headwinds with respect to approvals coming and some payment issues are there. But we are looking at increasing our spares for defense, almost doubling compared to last year. As far as mining and construction is concerned, we are very happy to inform you that we managed to sell our big dump trucks to Coal India on a trial come sale order for the 150 ton and the 190 ton, which hitherto used to be area for only the multinationals. And this is our focus. We would like to focus on all high-end equipments. We have also supplied the 180 ton electric excavator. We are also looking at a 875 horsepower dozer. So net-net, we are very bullish about the future.
Okay, that's good to hear. Mr. Hota, good morning. Can you give us a little more detail on this 3,000 crore order that you just won? What kind of margins would you enjoy on this particular order? And does the entire order come to you or is it a part of some JV?
No, this order comes to us totally. There's no JV. We may take some help from other design consultants like Hitachi and others, but the order is totally on account of BEML. It comes to us. The margins, as you would know, these would be a little a challenge, but we hope to make good, because this is the first time that we have been made eligible for such a big order. And you would perhaps be knowing that between the Chinese and BEML, the L1 and L2, the difference was less than 1%. Mm. So you can imagine what the market is headed towards. We are also told that ICF, which is part of the Indian Railways, is looking at producing a coach at a very low price, something like 6 to 7 crores. Mm. So the market is going to be extremely competitive. So we have to look at our procurement and ensure that we get the best price.
So when you say that the margins will be a challenge, what are we looking at? Are we looking at low single digit margins? Because your blended margins too have been around 6% or so.
See, in the metro, a single digit margin is a very good margin.
Okay.
In this one especially, it's going to be slightly stressed, the margin, because we have quoted very, very aggressively because we wanted to take this order. And so was the case with Chinese as well as Bombardier and others. All of them had quoted extremely aggressively. So I would foresee that the market in the future for metros is going to be very, very aggressive. So this would mean that the aggregate manufacturers who perhaps had a free run on the prices that they were charging us, they will have to look at charging as a percentage to the total sale price that we are going to have. So it's going to be a stretch for them as well.
Mr. Hota, just one final question, running out of time. So given the strength of your order book as well as the order pipeline, can you do better than, say, a 30% revenue growth in FY19? And also, going ahead, say, in FY20-21, now that you're bidding for much larger orders, what kind of a sustainable growth rate do you see for BEML?
See, I can just say that all the three verticals, we are very bullish. There's huge amount of potential. In the defense, for example, I had a big order of 1,400 crores of armored recovery vehicle, which had been stuck for some time for a certain policy dispensation. We are hopeful that that should also get resolved. As far as mining is concerned, as I said, the big dump trucks, the big dozers, the big equipments that we are looking at, that should give us a push. As far as rail and metro is concerned, I think there's a huge, huge potential. We already have a capacity to manufacture almost about close to 300 plus cars in a year. And the Indian market, I don't think will take more than 1,500 to 600 in a year. So between Alstom, Bombardier and us, we have a capacity of almost 1,000. I think there will be more upside in terms of rail orders. We are not very clear how the railway wants to handle it. Sometimes they want to do it themselves, sometimes they want to tender it out. But this year, we should look at better numbers, and next year onwards it should be much better.